Makes you think that I'm an answer if you ain't mine. Even if you call me up 100 times.
And we're back. Do your dance for me one time. Let that music play. We have 1K subs, so we celebrating all week. Friday, 6 p.m. Eastern time. 1K celebration stream. All right. Guys, I'm putting the link to join the Discord in the description, as well as pinned to the top of the chat. You can join the first 50 people for free. After that, we're going to shut it down. We're building a community of people who, you know, just want to have a good time. So let that song play. Ladies and gentlemen, go ahead and hit the like button, the red subscribe button, and then let's continue. Black Adam is a box office bust. Yeesh. Now, we need to go ahead and give credit to Ryan Connell at the RK Outpost, who actually warned everybody that this was going to be a box office fail. All right. Cost, what was it, like $250,000? A quarter billion to make. And let's see, Black Adam has hardly been given a hero's welcome in the box office, which run generating just $387 million globally after 7 weeks on the big screen. That is terrible. That is actually terrible. That may seem like a lot of coinage, especially in COVID times when movies of all shapes and sizes were struggling to reach pre-pandemic grosses at the box office. But Black Adam, a comic book adventure starring Dwayne Johnson as a villain who once promised to change the hierarchy of power in the Warner Brothers DC universe, didn't come cheap, costing $195 million to produce, and a big budget movie led by Dwayne Johnson, one of the biggest movie stars in the world, who plays against type here as a murderous anti-hero. Requires a worldwide marketing spend of $100 million, according to knowledgeable individuals. Insiders at Warner Brothers pushed back, saying that COVID-related box office limitations led the studio to scale back the global advertising campaign to $80 million. Doesn't matter, it still costs $250 million to make. As a result, the film needed to earn around $600 million worldwide to break even and to surpass that lofty benchmark to turn a profit, according to sources familiar with the financials. Yet box office experts believe Black Adam will stall out with less than $400 million globally, which is problematic since the movie theater owners get to keep around half of those sales. Yeesh! Now, the movie stands to lose $50 to $100 million in its theatrical run, according to the estimates of insiders as well as rival executives with knowledge of the similar production. Sources at Warner Brothers dispute those numbers, saying the movie will break even at $400 million. When the film was commissioned, the break-even was believed to be $450 million, but the figure has dropped given the particularities of the new home entertainment landscape, one in which Black Adam has overperformed projections. They also argue that the ancillary revenue streams have grown more profitable with shorter theatrical windows. Thanks to pandemic-era concessions, films hit home entertainment platforms in 33 days rather than 75, which reduces the money needed to revive marketing campaigns for a digital launch. Okay, so why did Black Adam flop? It's a great many reasons. You can blame post-pandemic trends, like people no longer rushing to the movies to go and see things and rather waiting for it to come out digitally or, you know, on streaming services, whatnot. Also, let's just keep it a buck. Nobody really knows who Black Adam is. I'm just keeping it a stack. You know what I'm saying? Spider-Man gets a movie. People are going to go. The only reason Captain Marvel made $1 billion was because it was sandwiched between Infinity War and Endgame. Or was it? Yeah, Infinity War and Endgame. Okay. Other than that, I mean, who else is like, Now, granted, we do have evidence of Marvel turning unknown properties into gold, Guardians of the Galaxy. But Guardians of the Galaxy was coming off of great momentum of what Marvel was already doing. And so at that point, Marvel had earned a reputation of everything they touching turning into gold. So once you saw that Marvel banner on there, people were going to go and see it. Additionally, Guardians of the Galaxy was a really good movie. Black Adam, I mean, like, it was fun to see him, you know, beat people's ass, but the story isn't really that great, so it wasn't much to talk about. It's not like you're sitting in a barbershop chair and people are like, damn, bro, you seen a new Black Adam movie? That shit was good. Nah, it wasn't like that at all. It was just a movie. It was like a 2 hour long, I don't even know if it was 2 hours, it was like a 2 hour long fan film. And I don't mean that in a disrespectful way, just like if you brought some fans together who wanted to make a film and say, you know, who would win in a fight with Black Adam versus Dr. Fate. That's what it was. It wasn't much story to be had there. So I'm not really surprised that it flopped. What does it mean for Black Adam going forward, though? He shouldn't have got his own movie. I'll tell you that. He should not have gotten his own movie. He should have been introduced as a Superman villain. That's what should have happened. And I know hindsight is 2020.
Started a tantrum, my baby. You had some plans with your man, just tell him to cancel, my baby. Slide to the crib, look like Dracula's mansion, my baby.